Next week at 7:30, AJP Taylor talks on the First World War. In a moment, the significance of the role women played in the American Civil War is highlighted in our documentary series.
I've got a story to tell you. It's all about spies. And if it's true, which I think it is, you boys are going to need a whole new organization.
John le Carré's Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy changed the language of espionage.
We have a mole, Jim. Very near the top. And the maggots are eating up the circus.
George, I've been sent to deliver you.
The return of the quintessential George Smiley in the award-winning adaptation of John le Carré's Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy. 9:05 tomorrow, BBC2.
This is BBC Two. Now we continue our series charting the events in the American Civil War. It's 1863 and the Confederate Army has retreated from the battlefield of Gettysburg. The nation is shocked by the multitude of deaths, but for many women and freed slaves, a new life is beginning, a new birth of freedom. In next week's program, General Sherman lays waste to the Confederacy from Atlanta to the sea, and General Lee's own estate at Arlington is turned into the National Cemetery, most hallowed ground. For a free fact sheet, send a stamped addressed envelope at least 9 by 12.5 to the Civil War, P.O. Box 1991, Burgess Hill, RH15, 8QY.
Now that the tribes have water, it is the equivalent of political power. And indeed, that's what this fight in the Supreme Court was all about.
A new series on BBC Two looks at the bizarre politics of water in the land of the drought busters.
We pay a lot more for a gallon of drinking water than we pay for a gallon of gasoline. And we need the drinking water.
Last month, these lifeguards saved a record 68 swimmers. They also saved 800 gallons of water by putting flow restrictors in their showers. Like us, they're helping California save water.
More powerful than petrol. Water Wars, 8:10, Wednesday, on 2.
Back to this evening, and at 10 o'clock, we continue our season of Africa on film with a true story set in Senegal in 1944, when African troops returning from the battlefields of Europe were greeted with hostility and contempt at the bleak Camp d'Atiaroué. Now on BBC Two, we return to the Crucible Theatre in Sheffield for the World Professional Snooker Championship.
A very good evening and welcome here to Saturday Night at the Snooker, our second Saturday night at the Embassy Professional Championship of the World. We're now deciding the quarter-finalists, and here's the state of the game. One quarter-finalist is already the defending champion, Stephen Hendry, who's beaten Elaine Robidoux 13 frames to 8. We've had a winner here today, that's Gary Wilkinson, who'd earlier knocked out Doug Mountjoy. Now he's beaten Martin Clark, and a good match it was. You may have been watching it this afternoon. Wilkinson winning 13 frames to 9. Down at the bottom, we know that Steve Davis is through into the quarterfinals, having beaten Tony Meo yesterday in the marathon match there, which went on for ages. Davis winning 13 frames to 6. The other news today is that Alan McManus is 8-7 up over Terry Griffiths, the 1979 champion. McManus dropped back a little day, but he still got that lead, and they play to a finish tonight. And John Parrott, the number 3 seed, has gone into a lead of 7 frames to 1 over Tony Knowles in their first session. 13 frames, of course, the target. And the big match tonight, no doubt at all, is Jimmy White against Neil Foles. Jimmy White, the number 4 seed, making his...